And finally, thank you. For those who saw Sunday's paper and read my story, the outpouring of support has been incredible, overwhelming. I had turned down requests to tell my story of domestic violence for years and years. I didn't want my dad, former Senator and Major General Jim Molan, to know the harrowing details of it. He knew about it, of course, but not the details. I never wanted to be defined by it, nor am I comfortable with anything that feels like victimhood. But as a woman started dying once every 4 days instead of what we used to think was awful, once a week at the hands of a partner, when more and more children, babies, seem to be losing their precious little lives to this insidious thing, I realised it was time. And that maybe, just maybe, and who knows, by sharing my story, it would help others stuck right now feel just that little bit less alone, less ashamed, and most importantly, less scared to ask for help. So to the thousands, and yes, thousands, it's been overwhelming, who have reached out to offer support, thank you. I am so fine now, I am safe. To those currently stuck in the cycle, I know all too well. I see you. To those who have contacted me stuck in that cycle, I am getting back to all of you one by one as soon as I can, and I promise this is just the start. I am a seriously, seriously annoying advocate and campaigner, as most politicians who know me will attest, and I am just getting started in this space.